Dear Papaji, your letter was a very unexpected and wonderful surprise to me. I didn't even know that you wrote letters. I will cherish it forever. I just started having video night at my house to show Satsang tapes. Everyone wanted to see one of you. Although it is difficult to hear you, you understand your words. I find myself in total bliss just watching and being with you. Your smile, laughter, radiance are contagious. Thank you for the photo. My favorite one of you around the cover of your second book. You are very beautiful. I am enclosing a photo of myself because I would like you to give me a spiritual name now, which is a reflection of my inner beauty. In 1990, I named myself Morgan, because it felt masculine, powerful. I needed the masculine because my parents wanted me to be a boy. So I always wanted to be one because I thought they would love me more, and I wanted a power name because I was molested and I didn't want to play the victim role anymore. Now I have healed myself and Morgan doesn't feel appropriate anymore. I was surprised when this came up for me to ask you for a name, as I never wanted one until now. I guess when you wake up, it's like being reborn, and when there is a birth, there is usually a name to go with the form. I was a flight attendant for 22 years. I got sick in 1988 and continued to work until I collapsed. I went through a lot of pain and suffering for many years, but the illness forced me to be instead of do, and in the quiet I am healed. My quest to be healed brought me to Mavi. So I am grateful I enjoy the simple life now. I love sunset walks satsangs, animals, nature, painting, being with friends, eating healthy, simple foods, photography, swimming, listening to music, reading, and most of all, being quiet. Thank you for taking the time to give me a new name. Forever grateful. I love you, Morgan. Birth name, 1990 name, Morgan Lee. Spiritual name, waiting for. Puneni, Puneni Hai. This girl, Morgan. This came by post?
Yes,
sir. I don't remember this girl. Do you see this girl?
This, yes, she was here.
Huh?
She was here.
Here? So I will write to her. Dipta. I am leaving tomorrow. It feels so crazy. It's like I have always been here and don't feel to go anywhere. For some practical reasons, I think I should go. So I will try and hope to be back soon. If not here, this was it, and I need to thank you immensely and say goodbye to you with immense love. Who is Deepta? Deepta, sure. Thank you for satsang. You are the true teacher. You are my teacher. Thank you. Thank you. The mind is having less and less power over me now. I feel free, new and fresh, in love and peace. Is it time for a new name? Deepta. When are you leaving and where?
Tomorrow.
Where?
Tomorrow.
Where?
I go to Pune for a few days to take some things. And then maybe I go to Europe or maybe I come back here. I will see.
Is it Deepta or Deepto?
Deepta.
Hmm?
Deepta. Deepta.
What's the meaning?
Burning candle.
Hmm?
Burning candle.
Hmm. So it's a good name, no? Deepa. Deepta, I don't know. It's not the correct word. So the correct word has to be corrected. Same word, but the correct thing is means not actually candle, but this is an Indian Indian some kind of, it was here, no, somewhere. So it was, then you put oil in it, then wick. Put the wick inside, the wick burns, you see. Wick burns solid. And you have to add oil in it. Whatever oil can be had, it can be put, and that word is deepam. Deepam instead of dipta. Okay? Keep your name this. Chalo. Now keep this letter also with you. Keep this letter also with you. You will remember your name.
Yes.
Okay? Annapurna. Chalo. Beloved Master, the first time I came to see you, something happened which I can only describe as an ever-present now, in which all past, including the knower, yet was untouched and knew itself only to be true. Then you asked me to speak, and I said, how can I stay here? And you said it was lost. Now I realize the fear arose in me, how can I function and perform my daily activities from this beingness, this mere presence, he says. Pritam has to come here. You don't use the word mere for daily activities. Daily activities. You don't say mere daily activities, but you use mere for presence, mere presence.
I said that in meaning there is nothing else.
Eh?
In saying that it's nothing else except.
Yeah, mere presence. Mere, what do you mean by mere for presence?
Mere meaning there's nothing else but presence, only presence.
Yes.
Only presence.
Only presence. But when you say mere presence, then it means you have got something better reality than presence, which is now, in your case, daily activities. What are the daily activities? They come, stay, go. They are not present. They are not present, isn't it? They are temporary. You take up to do something, and then after that it is done and finished. Then you pick up another one. And for presence, which is your nature, you call it mere presence, you see. How can this presence stay with you? How can it love you? How can it invite you? When you simply call, mere means just simply. So you are throwing away your own nature for daily activities. And daily activities you have done day before yesterday, did they satisfy you? And then yesterday, did they satisfy you? And today also. So this will be rolling throughout whole generations. and you will never get peace. Since then, I have been trying to recapture this beauty you have never captured at all. Why speak of recapturing? You have not seen it, you have not tasted it. This silence, since at that moment I knew it to be with me always, yet I find myself usually distracted. So how can you be distracted from presence? You can be distracted by daily activities, not by presence. And presence is always present when you are performing your daily activities. This presence is there, but you give more importance to the activity rather than this presence, this energy which makes you perform all the activities. You are missing it, you see. Now, question number one, can you help me to put aside the fear that arises in relation to how one can remain always in natural presence yet perform activities and functions that seem to require mental activities such as memory? So this presence will not be disturbed in your activities and functions because through this energy you are performing all the functions and activities of daily life and require mental activities such as memory. Yes, even the memory, you have some energy to use to recollect what has happened yesterday. So this energy comes from where? Which brings the things that are buried in the memory for years, which is this energy to recollect even. 10 years ago, I went to this place. 20 years ago, I lived with this person. What is this movement? Number two, also, is my longing for the beauty of presence that stays with me from the first visit only a longing for experience? Yes, you are longing for some experience to happen, but then and experience, you need mind, and no mind can see the presence. No mind. Mind needs presence. The present doesn't need mind to experience. Third, can you also explain the difference between sleep and wakeful presence? With love and gratitude, Pritam. I will leave on Tuesday. Presence between sleep and wakeful presence. So this sleep and wakeful are the states, and presence is not affected. These are states. They come, stay and go. Presence is always there. They move on presence. And this is some function of something that appears and disappears. And that is your own thoughts of the past that appear in the emptiness, and then they come in front of you and pass away. The other one comes like this. And presence is always there, waking, dreaming. Waking state, presence is there. You know everything. And then dreaming also. When you wake up from the dream, you remember, this has happened when I dreamt. And the dream persons went away, but the presence is still there. So dream presence is always there, the same. And the presence in the waking state, dream state, even the sleep state, you remember that I slept very well. I was not disturbed. I enjoyed my sleep. So this presence was looking these states, waking, dreaming and sleep. Presence is not affected. I am fed up of being married to a scared teddy bear and being a complaining sheep myself. In my relationship, there are a lot of habits and compromises based on fears. I really want this relationship to become a help in realizing the self. Papaji, can you help? Renu. Who's Renu? Come here. What do you mean that you want to continue the relationship also and realize the self? What do you mean? Why do you ask this question first of all? You're asking this question because relationship is not going on very well. Therefore, this question arises.
And I want to ask if there is a way that the relationship can become.
Yes, then relationships always. In relationship, every relationship, there is a fear. There is fear, has to be fear. When there's any relationship, there has to be fear. Where there are two, there has to be fear. Even when there is one, there has to be fear. One. You are afraid being alone. Then you take up someone. Again, you have fear that this person will leave me. Other person also thinks that you will leave him. So always there is a fear. No one is fear-free. Only you can remove the fear if you can look within your own self. And that is the zone where the fear cannot enter. So anybody who accompanies you, want to accompany you, you can go towards it, both of you. Then there is no fear. Looking for the same thing, same ideas, same desire, then you have no fear. People go on Mount Everest, see, Mount Everest, 29,000 feet altitude, and there's a team, maybe comprising of 5, 6, 10, 20 people going. Nobody is having fear of death because they all have the same desire to conquer the highest summit of the world. Only this thing in their mind. We are going to stand atop of the world. Then there is no fear. Whole team is there with you, having one thought in mind to conquer the summit. Then any number of people could be there, then there's no fear. We are so many people here sitting together, talking together, living together, we don't have any fear with each other. So this can happen when your thought is one and the same, and if you differ, then that life is worse than death. Even death can give you peace once for all, but this you have to die every day, living with the same man. So I don't think this is advisable association to stay with happily. Then you have got some different interest between each other that will not allow you to be in peace anytime.
Papa, is anywhere I can... It's very difficult for me
this is, we have to take a very bold decision. There was one young girl. So his parents and other relations wanted her to do as they do in the house, in the family. But she was always aspiring for freedom, meditating, which the other relations didn't like, her husband didn't like, the relations of the husband didn't like, her behavior was not accepted. So they said, this is not the behavior, you are a young girl, just married, and you are meditating, and your husband is not happy with you. And husband, sister also not happy. So sister of the husband, or her sister-in-law, that's what you call, is not happy with this new bride. She says, you have to accept the norms of our family and house. Now nobody gives advice, he doesn't know what is good behavior and what is bad behavior. She is meditating, loving God, spending most of the time in meditation, and they say it is a bad behavior. So she wrote, she had not seen this person, but she wrote a letter, sent a messenger, and she writes a letter, "Father, I do not know what's a good behavior, and my in-laws and other relations, they say I am not behaving well. I am just sitting quiet and meditating, and always I have no other thought in the mind. And they say you have to behave. Now please advise." So he writes a letter, he replies, he says, "The person, let him be any near and dear relation, if he doesn't agree with you on this behavior, he may be son, he may be husband, he may be father, he may be husband, or any other relation, reject them as your dire enemies. This is my advice. You step out. If they don't agree with you on this right track, you step out of the house, of the country even. This is the only best behavior that one should adopt. Don't listen to any person of the world. They are not on the right track. You leave the place. It's not a good place for you to stay, where everybody is foolish. They give you foolish advices. So you don't care. You are on the best track, and I am sure you will be among the lineage of the saints." And so it happened.
Papaji, Papaji but when that, there is
a... You do as you want to see. I can't say anything more on this thing. Margaret is well now. Where is Margaret? Huh? You see now. No, see. I told you. No. Yes. Very good. You are well now?
No. Yeah.
Huh? Yes, very good. He is very happy. David is very happy that you are here. He was asking, "Where is Margaret?" Whatever. Still this. What was this accident, no?
Yeah, the tempo driver was crazy. He was very fast and slipped on the side. Soon I was down.
Very good. Now you are quite healthy now.
Yeah.
No trouble. Because there is some infectious trouble during these days in the whole north of India, particularly this place. So you don't have this kind of infection, because I will advise those people who have this contact with this in flu or this infection, they are advised to stay at home, not come to satsang. And Dr. Yamuna will tell the precautions to be taken how to avoid this infection because this has spread throughout, but I am happy none of our people are having this contact because they don't mix with the general public, Sushi. But perchance if someone has this thing, so Dr. Yamuna will advise some medication or some precaution to be taken, but their advice, they have not to come to attend the satsang for the safety of everybody else, you see. And she will look after that person who's not attending the satsang. She will go at their place, and this information has to be passed on to her. So, my dear Papaji, moments of only love, light, joy from deep inside, expanding every moment. I thought you were in a very bad shape. You were suffering. But even then, you see, this helped, you know.
Yeah, very.
This moment, still you were remembering this, because I asked someone to go and see you, and you were meditating, even in this agony and trouble, you see, and suffering. And I look that you are better than before, isn't it? You look better than before. Expanding every moment, inviting just to fall into it, to be part of it, to become it itself, to be carried and moved in itself. Papaji, how to avoid being so much touched by this total fullness and purity? You want to avoid this? Or I don't read correctly, or what do you mean? How to avoid this being so much touched by total fullness and purity? So this is the best relationship with fullness and purity. This is the best relationship, and not like Reno to avoid. To avoid this thing, not to avoid this kind of relationship, and you want to avoid even purity. What do you mean?
I want to avoid being touched. I want to avoid being touched.
Yes,
because
you want
to push me out of quietness and awareness. When I feel touched, it's emotional. And I can't stay in a quiet and just aware.
So does it means this purity, when it has touched you, it doesn't stay with you. That's what you mean.
Yeah. When I'm touched, I'm out. So it's it clings at least to the mind again. Touch, attachment is at least again mind. And
you don't say it, no?
What the next it? Sentence.
Next line. So this is not enough. Is it not enough? This purity.
It is everything.
Is, eh?
It is everything.
Everything.
It is everything.
So if it is everything, how can it be avoided? If any particular thing is there you can avoid, how can you avoid which is everything, just like breeze?
Yeah.
Can you avoid breeze?
No. Huh? I want to just be in it. I just want to be in it, nothing else.
So when there is nothing else in your mind, you are that itself. This attachment is always a small back door for feelings, mind, ego, arrogance. They try for survival. It is surrender. Surrender into this love and light, which includes and embraces everything. Surrender from deep inside. Never in my lives. This invitation, this gift was so close to me, like here in Lucknow, together with you in Satsang. In this moment, another question arose. Who is the writer? What is this trouble with you now? Who is the writer? Who is the writer?
Me with Papaji.
I also doubt who is the writer myself. I cannot make up my mind. Who is the writer? Yes, for the last several weeks I am seeing this writer is still not, I have not yet made up my mind. Who is the writer? And nobody helped me. I asked Prashant, I asked Bharat Mitra, I asked Jamuna, I asked David, I asked Gopal, and then Almira also. Nobody helped me to decide who is the writer now. Today I want their help. And then this back door, I was asking this advice from the back door only, and now we are face to face.
Papaji, I love you. You are beautiful.
Anyway. And now, this is the time to leave my old name. I want to give up this name because it has concealed the writers. Please, Papaji, I ask for a new name today, calling my real self in deep love and trust you will give me an appropriate name. So what kind of name you want to see? I shouldn't make mistake.
When I thought on a new name in this situation, I remembered how the Red Indians do it. And I thought, oh, I hope the Red Indians will give me a name, Broken Wing or something like that.
Because, do you remember, we were together in Himalayas, Poonchatti, you know? Mm-hmm. We were also there, and some other 30 people were there. Mm. So we went to have a swim into the Ganga, isn't it?
Yeah.
Together, all this thing.
Yeah.
Then I sent I sent the woman, you go that side. That side, you swim, and we males, we will have this side, you go on behind the boulder, behind the rock. That is not fast also, current is not fast also. And you also had gone with them.
Yeah.
And then you came this side, where there were men, they said they don't allow you, they say you go to the men's side. So we allowed you to take bath. Then when they came, I said, why did you send her to us? Because they said, you said only women will separately take bath. And then you came to this side, everybody was looking at you. Why you don't go there? As I said, doesn't matter. I told them, you don't care, we don't care for sex. Let them be man or woman, doesn't matter. They can. This is the Ganga, you can have take bath. So now you ask for a name, therefore I said, this Margaret is a name of a male or female?
Female,
yes. 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 Female. Margaret is the name of female. Therefore I told to Bharat Mitra, this is Margaret is a female name. He said no. So we decided for the name which a male can use and female can use. Anybody can use. There's some common names you do not know by the name, because many times I receive letters I don't understand. I ask the people, is a female name, because they're asking for the name, and to write also, should I write Mrs. or Mr.? And then many people say, we do not know. Okay, then Margaret is a flower, no?
Yeah.
Margaret is a flower. So the same name I will give you of a flower which always faces the sun, from where the light comes, as you want to see the light, only light comes. So I will give you that name in which I cannot make mistake. Sun is male, moon is female. Why it is called so, I do not know. Sun. Nobody has seen the sex of the sun. No. Not of the moon. Therefore, I give you this name of the sunflower. Isn't it? Always facing the sun. And looking at the sunflower, nobody can say if she is a male or a female, no? Sunflower, yes. So that word is, name is, this name you can see, Surya. So, yes. Surya is a good name. I don't know if you remember the spelling.
Surya, I remember.
But if you pronounce the same word, you will become female. Same name. If you pronounce it, a long pronunciation, Suraya, becomes female. Surya, same spelling. Mm-hmm. You are masculine. If you make mistake, then but in your case, any mistake will be accepted. Nobody will say, I made a mistake. Because if he consult, the other man will have a different view. This is how the people are differing about this thing. Some people look like that, you see. yesterday we were seeing in the television also, and we could not decide if it was a man or a woman. Yesterday we saw him. So like this, Surya, okay?
Surya.
Yeah, I will give it to me. Sunflower. My beloved Master, where words cannot really express the peace I am feeling, songs somehow seem to get to the heart of the matter, to show my deep love and appreciation for all that you have given me. I would like to read a couple simple American Indian chants and love, and have whomever would like join in. I take you with me in my heart with love and gratitude. Lakshmi, you are leaving this afternoon. Okay. So we have yet. Have you checked if this air?
It's okay, this, Papaji.
Eh?
She could fly also yesterday.
Achha, I see.
There was something in the computer wrong in the...
So what happened to this?
In the morning they told her she cannot fly, but after you left I phoned the airlines and the flight was okay, so she flew.
She had a ticket, no?
She had a ticket.
So she went and she has
she
gone.
She went by flight.
To Switzerland, no?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Then why she was asking for this to go by train?
Because in the morning the travel agent told her that the Air India doesn't fly. But after you left I phoned Air India and they say they do fly.
Okay.
So she flew.
Okay. So the train services here today. So the plane services are here, okay, town.
Yeah.
Then you go. Then you go with our car is going to airport. Right? You can come here at 12:15. The car will pick you up from here itself, okay? Now what you want to speak, come here.
Papaji, I don't usually sing, so I've done dancing and acting, but never singing. So this is—I'm really a bit nervous here. So bear with me. I'd really like if a few people could join in. Actually, I have two American Indian chants.
Achha, okay.
And there's one other song that is not an Indian chant that I've always wanted to sing, but I never feel like I have a voice to do it. But it really expresses, they're not going to tears, because it really expresses what I feel. It's got a little Latin in it. So I'm an alto, not much of a soprano.
Your baggage is here or in? Here?
Yes.
Here. Chalo, if it is here, then. If it is here, then you can come. If it is here, your baggage is here, then you can come with us and start from our house. Eh?
Maybe I'll remember the song in the car.
Hmm? Interesting. Okay, very good. We would like to sing a song of gratitude to you. Divya, what? Chantam, Vedant, and Sahas. Chalo, you are invited today. Chalo, Sahas, Sahas, Divya. Chantam, Vedant. I'll give them place and get back. They need more place. Next part is very big. Chalo. There's no place. You can go back to your place. You also go back to your place. They need more place. The next party is a very big party, you know.
She's singing after
Thank you.
the cool wind that blows my dreams away. The love in your fire burns brighter than the sun at midday. As we carry your flame,
Gunar, Bijli, Karen, Gandharva, Margaret, Richard, then Annie, we, Majnu, Karin, Lisa, Brahma. Oh, yes, very good. You have to make a place. You are actually, I will have. Oh, yes, yes. He plays very well. You play again, alone. You play. Yes, very nice. He plays. But,
you for such an auspicious day, Papaji. I would love to receive a new name. I leave it entirely up to you.
You have come to sing a song, no? Here.
No way.
Then.
I think I'm accompanied by the group here.
Yes.
And then I'll follow. My memory for words and music comes and goes. So. Really, I'm much better at totally improvising.
Go for it.
Go for it.
And there aren't any words there.
Fine.
So,
thank you.